So hello everyone, so I hope you are all right. So let's start the video. So in my last lecture I talk about when a matrix is called diagonalizable. So let me repeat that. So we have said that a square matrix A is diagonalizable if A is, so a square matrix is diagonalizable if it is A is the matrix A is similar to a diagonal matrix. So a square matrix is diagonalizable if A is similar to a diagonal matrix. So in other way to say that, so if we have a matrix A, then the matrix is diagonalizable if we can find invertible matrix, which means the matrix has an inverse, show that A equals to P inverse DP, where the P is an invertible matrix and D is the diagonal matrix to which the matrix A is similar. So D is the corresponding diagonal matrix, then we will say that A is similar to a diagonal matrix, so the matrix A is diagonalizable. So to find the diagonal matrix, we have talked about a few more things in my last lecture. Especially I talk about that, suppose we have a matrix, so let me repeat that. Suppose then we will show by for a few example. So suppose we have a 2 by 2 matrix, so let A B a 2 by 2 matrix. So what we have done in my last lecture, so if A has, so suppose we have two eigenvector, one is x1, so one is x1, so A x1 is lambda 1 x1, so x1 is one of our eigenvector, and if we have another eigenvector which is x2 and which is lambda 2 x2, I'm not saying that always lambda 1 and lambda 2 have to be different. Lambda 1 may be equal to lambda 2, that's all allowed. So basically what we need two eigenvectors. Here we have an eigenvector x1 and here we have an eigenvector x2. So from that two eigenvector we made a matrix. I think you remember that thing. So we made a matrix x1 and x2. So for the matrix, x1 is the first column of the matrix and x2 is the second column of the matrix, and x1 itself, so x1 and x2 itself are 2 by 1 matrix, so there itself is a 2 by 1 matrix. So here we have 2 by 1 matrix, here we have also a 2 by 1 matrix, so it's become x is a 2 by 2 matrix, and we have seen that AX can be written as after putting the value, so we'll get some x into the diagonal matrix with diagonal entry lambda 1 0 0 lambda 2, where the lambda 1 and lambda 2 are the eigenvalue of the matrix, and from there what we have get from, we get that x inverse AX is similar to, so this equals to lambda 1 0 0 lambda 2. So we have seen that the matrix, this diagonal matrix is similar to the matrix A. So in another way to say that A is also similar to this diagonal matrix. So this is the thing, this is the method to solve, to find the matrix is diagonalizable or not. So when a matrix is, so in this whole problem, so what is the important thing from where we can decide that matrix is diagonalizable or not? The thing is that the matrix X is have to be an invertible matrix, otherwise we cannot find the X inverse. So the matrix X must have to be inverse, must be invertible, then the matrix A is diagonalizable. So that's why the matrix X is very important. This matrix X is called the modal matrix. So matrix X is called the modal matrix. Remember the name. So modal matrix, when X is modal matrix, when X is an invertible matrix, then we'll call this matrix with matrix formed by each column with eigenvectors of the matrix A is called a modal matrix. So if from here you can easily see that the matrix X is invertible if and only if the column X1 and X2 are linearly independent. Why? Because the when the column X1 and X2 are linearly independent, when X1 and X2 are linearly independent, when these two vectors are linearly independent, and we know from the chapter linear independency, so what we know about that, if two vectors are linearly independent, the matrix formed by these two vectors have to be with determinant non-zero. So with the matrix non-zero determinant, so because the determinant of X, so this matrix is basically X, so determinant of X is non-zero means X is invertible. So you can see from here that A is diagonalizable, which means A is similar to a diagonalizable, similar to a diagonal matrix if and only if the corresponding eigenvectors are, so this eigenvector and this eigenvector have to be linearly independent. So let me do it for a 3x3 matrix, and then we'll solve by taking a few particular examples. So again, let me repeat that part now by taking a 3x3 matrix. So what we have, so let me erase this part and talk about that. So here we go. So what we have, so we have to find in this type. So we have a matrix, so suppose A is a 3x3 matrix. So now A is a 3x3 matrix. So first actually we have to find the eigenvectors of A. So suppose A has three different eigenvectors, x1, lambda 1, x1, and A x2, lambda 2, x2, and A x3, lambda 3, x3. So we have, or I also want to repeat that lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 may not be different, they may be equal, but here we are taking three different eigenvector x1, x2, and x3. So from that eigenvector we're going to form a 3x3 matrix X with column, first column is the eigenvector x1, second column eigenvector x2, and third column eigenvector x3. Now from there we will find that AX have to, will going to be equals to basically AX1, AX2, and AX3. We have done it in my last lectures. So from there we can put the value lambda 1, X1, lambda 2, X2, lambda 3, X3, and from there we will get basically the matrix X into a diagonal matrix with entries lambda 1, 0, 0, 0, lambda 2, 0, 0, 0, lambda 3. So we get this diagonal matrix. So now we can write this from there, from this step. So remember that from this step we can write the next step, which is we can write in this form X inverse AX equals to the diagonal matrix D. So diagonal matrix D is this matrix. So diagonal matrix D is, so let me erase this part first. So where D is the matrix, so let me write that down. So diagonal matrix, we get a diagonal matrix D, so to which A is basically similar. So it is possible if and only if X has an inverse. So diagonal matrix D, so let me write that diagonal matrix D is the matrix lambda 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, lambda 2, 0, 0, 0, lambda 3. it is possible to write this in this form if and only if x has an inverse. So x means with x is a 3 by 3 matrix with first column with the first vector eigenvector x1 and eigenvector x2 and eigenvector x3. So in this way we will find the matrix x. So now we know that this matrix is the, so determinant of x is non-zero, which means x has an inverse if and only if. So if and only if, so these three eigenvectors are linearly independent to each other. So x1, x2 and x3 are linearly independent to each other, because if they are linearly independent, then determinant of the matrix will be equal to 0, and if the determinants are equal, then the vectors are linearly independent. So we know that from our previous lectures, basically in your class, what we have told you that 3 by 1, so a vector in 3 dimension is if we have 3 vector in 3 dimension, they are linearly independent if the matrix formed by these 3 vectors are linearly independent if the corresponding matrix with determinant non-zero. So you can form there, we can say that they are linearly independent if and only if determinant of x is 0. So that's all from there. So similarly we can talk about for a 4 by 4 matrix, for 5 by 5 matrix and so on. So from there what we get, so quickly let me write that. So when a square matrix n by n square matrix is diagonalizable, from this we can conclude that, so next step I have to write that, so next step I want to write that down. So from the next step I basically especially want to write in this form that, so here is the results we get from there. So here is the result. So we get, so a n by n square matrix, so n by n square matrix A is diagonalizable. So you can write S A B L E or Z A B L E, they may be do not make any difference. So we ask n by n square matrix A is diagonalizable if and only if, so if and only if, so if this is the criteria to check the square matrix is diagonalizable or not. So if and only if A has n, so here is a n by square matrix, so A has must have n linearly independent eigenvectors. So x main must have n linearly independent eigenvectors. So on that case we will say that the square matrix is diagonalizable. So let's check by a few example. So let me repeat that, then again we will go in to the example. So a square n by n square matrix is diagonalizable, so to check a matrix is diagonalizable or not, so suppose in exam or anywhere you have been asked to check a matrix is diagonalizable or not, so what you have to do, you have to find the eigenvectors of the matrix and to check that does n has n linearly independent eigenvectors or not. If n do not have the n linearly independent eigenvectors, then clearly A is not diagonalizable. Or in other words, if n has n linearly independent eigenvectors, then A must be diagonalizable. So let's go for some example. So let's do it. So I'm just taking an example. So what we're going to do, we take a matrix. So So let me give you the problem or exercise, or you may say that this is a one of the question. So here we have the question. So let me increase the thickness. So question, here is the question. So it says that suppose we have a matrix, check so verify the matrix A is diagonalizable or not. So verify the matrix A, so A is 2 2 1 and second row is 1 3 1 and third row is 1 2 2. So check that this matrix is diagonalizable. Verify the matrix is diagonalizable. So is diagonalizable or not. So verify this matrix is diagonalizable. So if it is diagonalizable, find the diagonalizable. So if it is diagonalizable, so next question may be so here from there are a few more questions may be asked. So you may be asked to find the, if it is diagonal, find the modal matrix, find the modal matrix of A, modal matrix of A. So this type question may be asked. So find the modal matrix of A. So they will be in the same problem. So find the modal matrix of A, or the they may ask you to find the diagonal matrix to which A is similar, matrix to which A is similar. So we have to find the diagonal matrix to which A is similar. So this type of question may be asked to you in exam. So verify the matrix is diagonalizable or not. Next, they may ask you to find, suppose it is given that you have find that out, you have somehow find out that the matrix is diagonalizable. Next task is to find the modal matrix for the matrix A, and the, or maybe you asked to find the diagonal matrix to which A is similar. So these three type of question may be asked to you in exam. So so let's do it one by one. So here let me change the color and let's solve this one by one. So first increase the thickness and we'll solve it one by one. So here is the solution. So I do not want to continue this part in this video. I want to think about it in this lectures. I just ask you to solve it. So use your brain to find the modal matrix and diagonal matrix. I already have discussed in theoretical way, not obviously not in by taking example. So in my next video obviously I going to solve these problems. So before that I just want to stop this video over here. So let it stop, what we have to find. So let me repeat that. So first, what you have to, your task is to, so here the step you have to follow. First step is to find the eigenvalues of A. So find eigenvalues of A. So this is your first task. Next task is, second task is to find the eigenvectors of A. Find the eigenvectors of A. So we have to find the eigenvectors of A. And third task is to check that do you have the three linearly independent eigenvectors. So do you have three linearly independent eigenvectors, eigenindependence, eigenvectors. So if it has three linearly independent eigenvectors, then obviously the matrix A is diagonalizable, and modal matrix will be, and modal matrix will be the matrix with each column are the eigenvectors with each column. So modal matrix, will be the matrix X. So modal matrix is X. So let me write it in phrase way. So modal matrix will be the matrix X with first column, suppose the vector, we get the eigenvector x1, second column eigenvector x2, and third column eigenvector x3, and from there we have a modal matrix, and obviously the diagonal matrix to which A is similar will be the corresponding eigenvectors. So suppose we have find the three eigenvector lambda 1 0 0 0 lambda 2 0 0 0 lambda 3, so to which the matrix must be similar. So obviously let me remind you again, the lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 may not be different, they may be equals. So in my next video I will go through the details to find all the stuff. So please watch the next my next video. So and I will recommend you, before watch the next video, please solve it by yourself. So thank you for watching. So we will see you in my next class.